Welcome to the iQ-Check Standard Extraction Protocol Training. And if you can say that, you already passed step one. Here I am in my lovely lab. On the left-hand side, we have DNA negative area. And follow me, on the right-hand side, we have our DNA positive area. We also have separate pipettes in each area to avoid contamination. So you can see I'm carrying my wonderful quick guide. It's excellent to keep with you at all times. And just print it out if it gets a bit grubby. Printed out a nice fresh one today. Here we are. We're going to take out our sample from the incubator. It's been going for 20 hours at 37 degrees. Yummy. Smells great. All right. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take 1 mL of sample into our 1.5 mL screw cap tube. So, open up the bag. This is one of those handy bags that has a filter in it. To avoid getting chunks, because you don't want chunky samples for your PCR. Now we're going to smoosh the bag, technical term, to get some sample, because you don't want to introduce the pipette into the bag. That also avoids contamination. So here we have 1 mL of sample into the tube. Screw on the lid, and our next step is centrifugation. And that goes for 5 minutes at 10,000 to 12,000 Gs. And ding, your sample has finished spinning. Let's remove the supernatant. You've got to be careful. You don't want to dislodge this pellet that you just created. Here we go. Take out that supernatant. Oh. Now you're ready to add your lysis reagent. 1 second. Here we have our kit lysis reagent. This goes on the stirrer. It's got a handy stir bar to keep it in solution. Now, if you're working with particular protocols, for example, for listeria, you want to use the grinding beads, and you'll add those to the lysis reagent at this point. But for this protocol, we don't need them. So let's add 200 microliters of the lysis reagent directly from on top of the stirrer so that everything is in solution. Add it to our sample. And we're going to now gently resuspend that pellet. At this point, you leave your sample for 10 minutes at 100 degrees. Now I'm off to make my PCR mix. So here we are in our DNA negative area. I've already changed my gloves and I've made up my PCR master mix with my probe and amplification mix using the table on the back of the quick guide. And I've remembered to include the positive and negative controls as well. So now I'm ready to add 45 microliters of our PCR mix to the plate. At this point, you want to be careful not to introduce any air. You can check in the pipette tip as you pull up the solution to make sure there's no air as you add it to the PCR plate. There we go, three added. Now we're going to take our positive and negative controls along with our PCR mix plate over to our DNA positive area. Here we are, PCR plate, your negative and positive controls go into the block, and you take your sample out from the heat block. We're going to spin down for 5 minutes at 10 to 12,000 Gs. Bing! And by the magic of TV, here is one I made earlier. We're now ready to add the samples. 5 microliters go into the wells that you've just filled with PCR mix. Be careful not to introduce any air. After you've added all of your sample, you add your negative and then your positive last to avoid any contamination issues. Seal your plate with optical caps and put it into your thermocycler. We have a small or a large one for 96 well plates. And then you hit start. And at that point, you can take a break and come back. When you get back, you'll have your wonderful results printed out and you can go through and look for positives and negatives. If you want to subscribe to our Bio-Rad YouTube channel for more wonderful videos, please feel free. And if you have any tips that you want to share, email us labnotes@bio-rad.com. Time for some analysis.